Matthew chapter 2, the verse number 19 and 20, and I read. But when Herod died, somebody say, when Herod died. When Herod died. But when Herod died, say it with some power. But when Herod died, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt and said, rise tenderly, take unto you the child and his mother, and go to the land of Israel, for those who sought the child's life are dead. For those who sought the child's life are dead. Hallelujah. I want to title my message, Your Herod Must Die. Look at somebody and tell the person, Your Herod Must Die. Your Herod Must Die. This morning, I want to plead with you by the mercies of God. Let too much walking cease. If you can sit down, just sit down quietly and hear the word of the Lord. I don't want any distraction. Because of what God is going to do this morning, the enemy have a way of distracting, making people move and walk all over the place, talking all over the place. But we are not going to give room for the enemy. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's pray. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus. This gathering is not a social gathering. The Bible says that where two or three are gathered in your name, there you are in the midst of them. And so, Father, we know that we have not gathered here in our name, but we have gathered in the name of the Lord. And so you are here in the midst of us. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that let every resistance in the spirit cease. Let every opposition cease. Let every activity of the enemy come to a halt. I decree in the name of Jesus, let your word have free course. Father, illuminate the understanding of your people. Father, mantle me with fresh oil and with fresh fire. I pray in the name of Jesus, let me speak as your oracle. Let your word in my mouth be fire. Let the hearts of the people be dry grass. I declare that let there be deliverance and healing and miracle and salvation and liberation and emancipation in the house. Anybody here with any expectation of you, Father, meet them at the point of their expectation. And let the powers of darkness and territorial spirit and every forces of darkness from the kingdom of Satan that will try to resist, Father, this service and the operations of the Holy Spirit and the maneuverings of the Holy Spirit, I declare in the name of Jesus, let their activity, O God, be neutralized, diluted, and rendered non-effect by the blood of Jesus. Father, I thank you that you will bless us. I thank you that you will lift us to our next level. In Jesus' name, and everybody say amen. Amen. Look at somebody and tell the person, your Herod must die. The way you are even saying, Herod will be alive. Look at them. Tell them, your Herod must die. Hallelujah. That is the problem of the church today. I will talk about it shortly. I want you to say for the last time, your Herod must die. Now, the scripture that we just read, it talks about Jesus, Joseph, Mary, and Herod. The Bible says that Jesus, there was a prophecy in the Old Testament that Jesus was going to be born. And everybody was waiting for the manifestation of this prophecy that Messiah will come. So the Messiah was born, and the Bible says that there were three wise men. I want to rush through this because you know the story. I have a lot of grounds to cover. And so the Bible says that there were these three wise men or the magi were saw the star appeared in the skies, and they realized that this star is a sign that the Messiah has been born and the king has been born. And so whilst they follow the star to locate the Messiah, Jesus Christ, they came into King Herod's palace. And they started making an inquiry of this new king that has been born. Now Herod had no idea that there is a new king that has been born, because at the time, he was the only king that is suppressing everybody. He was the only king over the entire Israel. And so the Bible says that he told these three magi that, you know what, when you find this king, just let me know so that I can go and worship this king. To cut a long story short, after these three people have seen the Savior and presented gifts to him, the Bible says that an angel of the Lord spoke to them through a dream that they shouldn't go back to Herod and they shouldn't use the same route. They should change their route. So they changed their route. It wasn't long. The Bible says that an angel of the Lord appeared in a dream to Joseph and told Joseph that, Joseph, take the child and your wife. Go to Egypt and stay in Egypt until I have asked you to come back, because Herod is after the child. I want you to say this after me. Is Herod after me? Just say it. Or say it well. You will understand very soon. So the Bible says that they stayed in Egypt. And whilst they were in Egypt, Herod was waiting for these three wise men to come back to him to give him the report. He waited for solid 2 years, and it was to no avail. These three wise men never showed up. And so the Bible says that Herod was very furious and Herod was very angry, and he decided that he was going to eliminate and terminate all the children between 1 month old to 2 years. He was going to eliminate and terminate each and every one of them because of the new king that has been born and because of the Savior, the Messiah that has been born. Now, let me talk to you about who Herod is so that you will have understanding, illumination, a revelation of who Herod is. You got to understand that Herod was a king. And so Herod was just not an ordinary human being, and he wasn't just a commoner. Herod was a king. In other words, spiritually, Herod was a principality. Herod wasn't just a demon. Herod wasn't just a spirit. Herod was a principality. And the assignment of Herod is to terminate people's glory from their inception. To terminate, to abort, to neutralize, to circumvent people's glory from their inception. Now, I want you to understand that if you don't attack Herod, Herod will not make you shine. Because what Herod does is to make sure that your glory doesn't come into being. Your glory doesn't come into manifestation. Now, I want you to understand that in the battle of life, whilst you are struggling to succeed, there is somebody struggling to destroy you. I will repeat that for free. No, I'm not talking to the right people. Let me talk to these people. I said, in the battle of life, whilst you are struggling to succeed, there is somebody struggling to destroy you. That is the battle of life. And so if you are here, you think that whilst you are struggling to excel and to succeed, everything is well with you, I want you to understand that you are lying. There is somebody that has been positioned. There is an Herod that has determined and purpose that before you shine, he will eliminate you. Before you shine, before you lift up your head, he will kill you. Before you become somebody, he will eliminate you. There are so many that have died prematurely. There are some of you, your dreams have died prematurely. Your glory has died prematurely. Your rising up has died prematurely. Your promotion has died prematurely. Your marriage, your relationship has died prematurely because they are Herods. And as long as there is a Herod, Herod will come after you. Herod will come after your life. Herod will come after your finances. Herod will come after your family. Herod will come after your children. That is why in this life, Christianity is not a religion. It is not. Christianity, it is not for wimps. Christianity for strong men and women. Christianity is not for people who are weak. Christianity is for people who are strong. People who are very tenacious. People who have confidence. People who have a boldness like a lion. Who have a tenacity of a bulldog. Let me tell you, Christianity is not for defensive mechanism. Christianity, we are for the offensive. If you are going to destroy Herod, you got to be at the offensive side. If you are not at the offensive side, Herod is going to eliminate you. Herod is going to kill you. Herod is going to bring shame upon you. Herod is going to bring reproach upon you. Herod will make sure that you don't come into your promise. That is why John the Baptist was killed. In fact, John the Baptist's head was offered on a platter as a gift to Salome. Because Herod killed John the Baptist, beheaded him, before John the Baptist could rise up and become everything that God had purposed and determined for him to become, Herod beheaded him. And the reason why Herod beheaded John the Baptist, because John the Baptist was at the defensive side. He wasn't at the offensive side. John the Baptist thought that Christianity was a religion. But Christianity is not a religion. That is why Jesus said, from the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. What Jesus was saying is this. Jesus was saying that if John the Baptist had attacked Herod, he wouldn't have died. If John the Baptist would have been at the offensive side, he wouldn't have been beheaded. Beloved, if you don't attack the Herod in your life, if you don't eliminate the Herod in your life, the Herod that will not let you rest, the Herod that have made you a fugitive, you are all over the place and you are not able to settle, Herod will make sure that he eliminates you. But today I have come in the volumes of the book that before Herod eliminates you, we will eliminate Herod. If you believe it, shall fire. Herod must die. Let me tell you, Herod would die at all costs. Any Herod that is in your life, that is pestering your life, any Herod that is after your destiny, any Herod that is after your children, any Herod that is after your finances, any Herod that is after your life, I declare by the finger of God and by the power of the Holy Spirit, let the Lord arise and let the Herods be scattered. If you believe it, shout yes. If Herod is after our Savior, Herod can be after anybody. If Herod was after Jesus Christ, Herod is after you. And the only reason why an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph and told Joseph that take the child to Egypt until I've asked you to return was because the child was helpless. The child couldn't fight at that time. The child couldn't be on the offensive side. And so God himself had to rescue the child from the terrain, from the domain of Herod to another country. Until God has spoken again for him to return. And the Bible says that Herod killed all the children in Ramah. And so the Bible says in Jeremiah chapter 31, the verse number 15, it says that there is weeping, there is a voice in Ramah. There is a voice in Ramah, and the voice that is in Ramah, it is a voice of mourning and it is a voice of weeping. And the Bible says that Rachel is weeping for her children and she refuses to be comforted because her children are no more. Beloved, if you don't kill your Herod will make you mourn. If you don't kill your Herod will make you weep. If you don't kill your Herod will eliminate everything that brings you joy and peace, everything that brings you fulfillment, everything that brings you jubilation, your Herod will eliminate it. But today I have come. Every Herod that is in your life, every Herod that is positioned in your life, that doesn't want you to see the hand of God, that doesn't want you to see the glory of God, every Herod that have delayed the purposes of God concerning your life, every Herod that have delayed the manifestation of the things that God has said concerning your life, today I declare in the name of Jesus, let all the Herod in this house, let them die. Let all the Herod in your life, let them die, so that the glory of God will be revealed, so that the blessings of God will be revealed. If you believe it, shout fire. Herod must die. Beloved, Herod will not masquerade himself. Herod will not come in the form of caricature. Herod will not come wearing dark clothes. Herod will not show up with horns. Herod always shows up very subtle and very cunning. Because when he was speaking to the three wise men, he told them that, don't worry, when you see these children, you just come and tell me so that I can also go and worship him. Let me tell you, the spirit of Herod is a manipulative spirit. The spirit of Herod is pretentious spirit. The spirit of Herod is hypocritical spirit. The spirit of Herod is a sycophant spirit. If you don't have strong discernment, you will not be able to discern the spirit of Herod. And the spirit of Herod is killing us one by one. It's eliminating and aborting our destiny one by one. Do you know how many people that couldn't shine before they died? Do you know how many people? Depression have killed so many people. Oppression has killed so many people. The tiredness of life had killed so many people because of the spirit of Herod. The Bible says that, and Herod killed James. Before the apostle James could rise up to his full potential and manifest the giftings of God and the glory of God and to fulfill his assignment and destiny, the Bible says that, and Herod killed James. And when Herod killed James, he quickly apprehended Peter and jailed Peter and waiting for Easter to kill Peter. And the reason was because he knew that upon this rock shall the church be built, because Jesus have said of Peter that your name is Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gate of hell shall not prevail against him. And so he knew that in life Peter is going to shine in his ministry. The devil is looking for people who are going to shine in life, and he wants to eliminate them before they shine. He wants to abort their purposes before they shine. He wants to destroy them before they become anybody. But I declare in the name of Jesus that may the angel of death visit Herod in the name of Jesus. Herod is a spirit. Herod is a principality. Herod is a demon. Herod will not make you rest. Herod will make you have sleepless night. But today we have not come to our defensive side. We have come at the offensive side. And we say, wherever Herod is, if Herod is at the left or the right, if Herod is at the north or the south, we are coming after Herod in the name of Jesus. We are coming after Herod by the blood of Jesus. We are coming after Herod by the authority given to us. Any Herod that is in your life, today they will go. I said they will go. I said they will go. Wherever they are hiding, they will go by the blood of Jesus. If your believers shall fire, Herod must go. Or look at somebody and tell the person, Herod must go. Herod must go. Herod is not just going to go. Herod is going to die. Herod is going to die. The Bible says that when Peter was apprehended by Herod, and Peter was jailed and put in prison, waiting to be killed, the Bible says that the church went into prayer. The church went into prayer. Let me tell you, the only way you can destroy Herod is to go into prayer. Go into prayer. Herod dreads prayer. There are levels and there are dimensions of prayer. There is some dimension that when you enter into prayer, anything that contends with your destiny must come to a halt. There are levels and there are dimensions of prayer that causes the heavens to come to a standstill and causes the earth to be still. There are dimensions and levels of prayer that makes the kingdom of darkness not to be able to function. There are levels and dimensions of prayer that places supernatural and internal embargo upon the activities and the operations and the maneuverings of the enemy. Today I have come in the volumes of the book, every Luciferian spirit, every diabolical activity in your life, every satanic maneuver is in your life, by the blood of Jesus, I declare that they have come to a halt. I said they have come to a halt. Anybody, any herald that wants you dead, they would die and you will still be alive. Oh, if you believe it, shout yes. And the Bible says that the church went into serious warfare. The reason why over the years Herod have destroyed a lot of lives is because we have left Herod to do whatever he wants to do. Whatever he wants to do. He has the freedom and the liberty to do whatever he wants to do. The church said, you have killed James, but we will not allow you to kill Peter. Hey, the devil has taken away your job, but you will not allow him to take away your joy. The devil have brought shame and disgrace upon you, but today you are saying enough is enough. The devil have been playing games with you and pushing you around, but today you have said that devil, you have pushed me to the wall and I am coming after you with every fiber of my being and with every ounce of my blood. I am determined and purpose that today either you die or I die. And because I cannot die, you are going to go. Oh, I said they are going to go. Oh, I said they are going to go. Can I work this thing? The Bible says that the church started praying. And the church started praying. And I believe this is the prayer they pray. They said, you principality called Herod, you have killed James and we have been quiet, but we will not allow you to kill Peter. And so we position ourselves in the heavens. We speak from the throne room perspective. We invoke the therapeutic powers of the blood. We position ourselves by the authority in the word. We employ the services of the name of Jesus. And we decree by the finger of God that you will not kill Peter. Before you try to kill Peter, you will die. Oh, I said before they try to kill you, they will die. If you believe it, shout, yeah. I have not come to joke. I have not come to play. I have come to war against the Herods in your life. I have come to eliminate the Herods in your life. I have come to kill the Herods in your life. The Bible makes us understand that power and authority has been given to us. Jesus told the disciples, from today I have given you authority. I have given you power. I have given you the keys. Whatsoever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatsoever you loose on earth shall be loose in heaven. Other translation says that whatever you allow on the earth shall be allowed in heaven. And whatever you disallow on the earth shall be disallowed in heaven. Today we have come to disallow the errors. We have come to disallow them. So the Bible says that Herod set the dates, and Herod sat on his throne and began to give philosophical speeches, giving an intellectual speeches, using all kinds of phonetics and lingo to persuade the people and to make himself powerful. And the Bible says that whilst he was talking, an angel of the Lord was dispatched, and the angel of the Lord entered into the prison. Now, the Bible makes us understand in Acts chapter 12 that Peter wasn't just in the prison. Peter was in the innermost court of the prison. Before you could get to Peter, you must pass through three gates to get to Peter. Because they are making sure that Peter is locked up and there was no way out that he could come out. When Herod gets hold of you, he will lock you, shut you down, that nobody will be able to rescue you. That is why we must go after Herod. This Herod is not only a spirit, it's also a human being. So the Bible says that the angel of the Lord entered into the prison and rescued Peter from the prison without even the knowledge of Peter, whilst the church was still praying. Oh, can I work this thing? Because I'm getting to the point that I like. Oh, can I preach like I feel it? And so the Bible says that whilst the apostles and the early church were praying, and whilst Peter was rescued and Peter was brought to where they were praying, the Bible says that whilst Herod was sitting down and was giving his speech, all of a sudden, an angel of the Lord showed up. And the Bible says that the angel of the Lord struck him. And when the angel of the Lord struck him right in the presence of the multitude, the Bible says that he fell and died. And immediately, worms ate him up. I have a rhema word for somebody. Your Herod will not die in secret. They will not die in secret. They will die in the open. So that everybody will see them for who they are. All this while they have been pretending. All this while they have been hiding. But today, your prayer will locate them. Oh, I said your prayer will locate them. If they are in the bottom of the sea, your prayer will locate them over there. If they are in their covens, your prayer will locate them over there. If they are in their shrine, your prayer will locate them over there. Wherever they are hiding, your prayer will locate them and bring them into the public domain. And guess what? The Bible says that the worms ate him up immediately. Get ready. God is about to send some worms after your Herod. Isn't it amazing? How can somebody die and immediately worms will eat him up? It's got to be the finger of God. It doesn't happen. It doesn't happen. And you know the reason why that happened? I feel this thing. What I'm about to say, I feel it. The reason why Herod died, fell and died, and worms ate him up was because God wanted to make sure that Herod is truly dead. And the worms eat him up so that there will be no trace of Herod. Hey, your Herod, eh? There will be no trace of them. Their lineage will be wiped out, and their generation will be wiped out, because they have touched the seed of the righteous. You cannot touch the seed of the righteous and go scot-free. You cannot touch the seed of the righteous and rejoice. Nobody contends with God and succeed. Anybody that touched you have touched God, because you are the apple of God's eye. I came to announce to the Herods that are playing with your life, that they don't know, they are not playing with you, but they are playing with the Almighty God. Beloved, I want you to understand that the Bible says that you are the weapon of warfare in the hands of the Almighty God. You are a battle ass in the hands of the Almighty God. Let me tell you, the Lord is your refuge and your fortress. The Lord is your stronghold, is your shepherd. I came to announce to somebody that any Herod that have caused you pain, any Herod that have brought disgrace in your life, any Herod that have made you wept, any Herod that have made you doubt God, today your Herod is going to die. Listen to me. The Bible says that, and Haman plotted against the Jews. And what he plotted against the Jews, the Bible says the opposite occurred. Some translation says that, and the contrary occurred. Other translation says that what he plotted, it came upon him. Hey, let me tell you, whatever Herod has plotted against you, it will come upon Herod. Oh, I said it will come upon Herod. Hey. shine. Look at somebody and tell the person, I will shine. I will shine. You will shine. Hey, you will shine. You will manifest the glory of God. If God says that you are blessed, God will bless you. Let me tell you, it is the spirit of Herod that makes people die prematurely before they even enjoy their prosperity. Because it is not of God for God to bless you and make you die without enjoying the blessing. It is the spirit of Herod. The blessing comes just when you are about to enjoy it, they eliminate you. But let me tell you, this prosperity, you will live so long. You will enjoy it so long. Until you yourself, you will tell God, God, now I am tired. Take me home. The spirit of Herod. The spirit of Herod will make you doubt God. John the Baptist. A whole John the Baptist, the forerunner of the Messiah. When he was apprehended and put in prison, he, as a matter of fact, he was the one that even introduced Jesus. He said, behold the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of humanity. It was him that introduced the Messiah. But when Herod arrested him and put him in prison, he sent somebody to go and find out if he is the Jesus that we are expecting or we should expect another. Can you imagine that? Jesus even got angry and said, hey, go and tell this man that the blind is seeing and the crippled are walking and the dead is being raised. How can John the Baptist, who introduced Jesus, begin to doubt that he is the Messiah? That is how the spirit of Herod operates. There are some of you, you have heard the voice of God. God have revealed things to you through dream. God have spoken to you prophetically. You know and you know that God has blessed you and God is going to prosper you and elevate you and make you great. But now you are beginning to doubt whether you truly heard the voice of God or not. It is the spirit of Herod. The spirit of Herod. Hey, don't allow the spirit of Herod to hang around you. Don't allow it. The spirit of Herod must go. The spirit of Herod must die. Because if you don't kill the Herod in your life, the Herod will go after your children and go after your children's children. If you don't kill the Herod will go after your siblings. Herod must go. Hey, today, somebody say today. Oh, am I talking to the right congregation? Somebody say today. Any Herod assigned to my life, to my destiny, to my marriage, to my business, to my favor, to my promotion, to my ministry, I command you, wherever you are, wherever you are, die, die by fire, by thunder, by lightning, die, 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 say yeah. Sit down. I am announcing to all the Herod, you have met your match. You have met your match. All the Herods that are in your life, Herods that are quoting scriptures, Herods that are praying in tongues, Herods that are praising with us, today your time has come. Today your end has come. You will not be able to function. You will not be able to operate. Because today you will be exposed. I said they will be exposed. I said they will be exposed. Wherever they are, fire will catch them. Somebody say fire. Somebody say fire. Somebody say fire. Somebody say fire. How is it that you have all the qualifications but you cannot get a job? The spirit of Herod. How is it that you are pretty and you are beautiful but no man is looking at you? It's the spirit of Herod. How come that anytime people promises you, just when they are about to fulfill their promise, something happens and they disappoint you? The spirit of Herod. It is the spirit of Herod that makes you cry. It is the spirit of Herod that makes you weep. It is the spirit of Herod that aborts the miracles. It is the spirit of Herod that delays the blessings of God in your life. That is why Herod cannot live today. I said Herod cannot live. Herod cannot live. We have come. We are waging war against Herod. We are waging war. We are waging war against any Herod. There are some of you, you don't only have Herod, you have Herods. It's not singular, plural. They are all over the place. But today, if they gather together, they will be broken in pieces. Their counsel will not stand, and their counsel will not prevail. And today, when the Herods gather, there will be confusion among them. When the Herods gather and they begin to speak, their tongue will cleave to the roof of their teeth. When the Herods gather to begin to speak and to begin to operate and to begin to plan against your life and your destiny, God will rise up in his fury. God will rise up in his indignation. God will rise up in his judgment, and he will eliminate each and every one of them. Let me tell you the reason why God is going to eliminate your Herod, because this particular season you must give your testimony. Oh, you didn't hear what I said. Hey, this year, this month, you will give your testimony. You will give your, that door will open. That favor will come. That breakthrough will come. That blessing will come. That contract will come. That promotion will come. That elevation will come. This is the time. If your beloved shouts, yeah. Somebody say yeah. Somebody say yeah. That is why I came to announce to all the heralds that have been assigned against Eagle Chapel, as long as I am here and as long as Jesus is my Lord, you will not be able to prevail against Eagle Chapel. This church will expand. This church will grow. The move of the Spirit will be in this church. It shall be called House of Miracles. It shall be called House of Prayer. It shall be called House of Deliverance. It shall be called House of Salvation. If you believe it, shout, yeah! Herod must go. Oh, slap three people and tell them, Herod, you must go. Herod must go. Herod must go. In fact, Herod didn't see this service coming. They didn't see it. If they had seen it, they would have tried to stop it. But we are unstoppable. Oh, look at somebody and tell them, we are unstoppable. We have taken them by surprise. They didn't know what hit them. They didn't know what happened last night. Let me tell you what happened last night. Last night, God conveyed a meeting, an emergency meeting. This meeting, we call it 911. Everybody came together. The angels came together. The 24 elders came together. Jesus was there. In fact, they even summoned the Holy Spirit to come back to heaven so that they can have this meeting. When the meeting was conducted by God, God came to a conclusion that this Herod had been worrying his children. And so this morning, let my children eliminate them. Hey, you have the power. You have the power. Hey, today, Herod cannot dodge your bullets. Herod cannot dodge your bomb. Hey, today, your prayer will be converted to an hydrogen bomb. Some will be converted to an atomic bomb. Some will be converted to AK-47. I don't know who I came to talk to, but I came to announce to somebody that wherever your Herod is, when you shoot, you will not miss your target. Oh, somebody say, I will not miss my target. Somebody say, I will not miss my target. If your beloved shall fire, somebody say, fire. Yeah, 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 yeah. Rise on your feet. Let's begin to deal with Herod. Lift up your right hand. Today, Herod, you are lying. Hey, this year, the half of the year, let me tell you, testimonies will run after you. It will run after you. Breakthroughs will run after you. In fact, it is not going to be every day. Every hour will be a testimony. Every hour. will be a testimony. They have no idea. Lift up your right hand. Make this declaration after me. In the name of Jesus. Lift up your right hand. In the name of Jesus. Any Herod pursuing my life. Any Herod pursuing my marriage. Any Herod pursuing my career. Any Herod pursuing my favor. Any Herod pursuing my glory. Any Herod pursuing my glory. Any Herod pursuing my elevation. Any Herod pursuing my prosperity. Today I command you, wherever you are, whether in the house or outside the house, if you are the north or the south or the east or the west, before me, behind me, today I release blood bullets, and I declare, let the blood bullet of Jesus Christ hit your chest. Hit your chest now. Now, now, by fire, 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 Herod, Herod, die, 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 by fire, by fire, by fire. Clap your hands and begin to pray. Rakapatosai. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Rokopotayas. Rekepetesh. Rekepotokai. Rekapotaye. Rekepetaye. 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 Rokopoto. Rekepelias. Rekepetoa. Every Herod, pestering your life. Every Herod, inhibiting your life. Every Herod, limiting you. Every Herod that doesn't want you to excel, let Herod die. Herod die. Herod die. Herod be eliminated in the name of Jesus. Marua kapaya. Rekepete, 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 rekepete. Malu kapaya. Rekepelias, rekepetayoha, rekapolias, rekepete, rekapotaye. Clap your hands and pray. Clap your hands and pray. Rokopoto, 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 rekepete, rekepete, rekepete. Open your mouth and pray. Rakapataya, rakapataya, rakapataya. Rakapataya, rakapataya, rokopopapaya, rekepelias, rekepotoa, rekepetaye, rekapantoa, rekepepapaya, rekepelia, rekepepapaya, rekepelia, rekapolua, rakapantoa, rekepetaye, rekepetaye, rokopotoa, rekapantoa, rekepetoa, rakapantoa. Rekapo papaya, rekapo luas, rekapanto kapea, rekepe tokoa, rekapo lua kapea, rekapantoa, rekapo papaya, rakapo lua, rekepe lia kapoa, rakapantoa, rekapo papaya, rekapo papaya, rekapalia, rekapantoa, rekepe lia, rekapo tayeha, in the name of Jesus. Lift up your hands. Now, let me talk to you before we lift up our hands. Some of you will be wondering that why should Herod die? Why don't we leave Herod to live? Let me tell you, until Herod dies, you cannot fulfill your assignment. That is why the Bible says that when God, the angel of the Lord, spoke to Joseph and told Joseph, take the child to Egypt. God waited until he had killed Herod. Because when the angel showed up again, the angel told Joseph that Herod is dead. Now you can go back. Hey,
Until Herod dies, the glory will not manifest. Until Herod dies, your dreams will not come to realization. Until Herod dies, you will not see the glory of God. Until Herod dies, that marriage will not happen, because Herod is holding your wedding ring. Herod is holding your prosperity. Herod is holding your blessing. That is why at all costs, Herod must die. This is not Pastor Grant. This is scripture. Herod must die. He said, now that Herod is dead, you can go back. Go and ask Moses. One of the reasons why Moses said, no, I won't go to Egypt, because they were after him to kill him. And check the scriptures, what God said to Moses. He said, those who are dead in your life, they are dead. There are some people, they must go before you can solve. As long as they are there, your troubles will be compounding and compounding and compounding, as long as they are there. Don't be surprised that after this service, you will receive calls and they will tell you, this person is dead, that person is dead, this person is dead, that person is dead. Don't be surprised. Lift up your right hand. We have not come. This is not playing church. Here we mean business. It's not a joke. Why should I? You should have been sleeping. You came to church to have an encounter with God. You came to church because you are tired at where you are. You have been there for so long. You have become stagnant. It's about time you move into your promise. And before you can move into your promise, Herod must go. Lift up your right hand. We will crush the head of Herod. The Bible says that the word of God is like hammer that breaks rocks into pieces. Hammer. Somebody say, I deploy the hammer.
I deploy the hammer.
The way you are even saying it. Say it my way. I deploy the hammer.
I deploy the hammer.
Sometimes the way you even say it, it terrorizes the Herod. The first time I heard of this man's name, Archbishop Benson Idahosa. The name Idahosa. The Idahosa itself, when the devil hears, he begins to shiver. What are you talking about? Lift up your hands. Maybe I need to change grant and put some. Lift up your right hand. We are laughing, but it's serious. Lift up your right hand.
Any Herod
that has taken away my joy.
Any Herod
that has taken my miracle.
Any Herod
that has taken away my peace.
Any Herod
that has taken away my job.
Any Herod
that has taken away my expansion.
Any Herod
that has taken away my career.
By the hammer of the word,
I crush them.
I crush them.
I break them
into pieces
right now.
Right now.
Right now.
Right now.
Now, all of you, turn to this side. Look at this wall. Lift up your right hand. These things, we call it prophetic tokens and symbols. Yes. Turn to them. All the Herods on this side. No, I didn't say you should say it. I like that. You are aggressive. You didn't come to play. Now, look at me. All the Herod on this side. Hey. Okay, you know what? Let's just do the declaration. Look at this side.
All the Herods
facing me.
And
all the Herods
that I am facing.
Today,
your end
has come.
I command you.
If you are coming
from this direction,
meet
your untimely death
now,
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 by fire.
Herod,
Herod,
from this direction,
die,
die,
die.
Leave my life alone.
Leave my destiny alone.
Leave my finances alone.
Leave my favor alone. Leave my breakthrough alone. Leave my elevation alone. Leave my peace alone. Leave my family alone. Leave my children alone. No, 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 no. Herod, die. Herod, die. Fire, 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 fire. Herod, you are dead.
Stand towards me. Stretch forth your hands. Let me come here so that your fire will not. We are all facing this direction. The same declaration. Because if I stand here, something will hit me. So let me. I'm not your herald. Stretch forth your hands. I want you to make this declaration after me. In the name of Jesus. Every herald coming up against me from this direction, in the name of Jesus, cut fire, cut fire, cut fire, cut fire. Every herald holding my marriage, cut fire and leave it. Every herald holding my prosperity, cut fire and leave it. Every herald holding my peace, cut fire and leave it. Every herald, every herald assigned against my destiny from this direction, hear the word of the Lord. Your time has come, and I declare, die, 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 die now. By fire, by fire, die, die. Herod, you are dead.
Face this side. We are not leaving room for any Herod to operate. Wherever he comes from, he will meet his untimely death. Stretch your hands. Some of you have not done exercise for so long. Burn some calories. Stretch forth your hands. Make the declaration after me.
In the name of Jesus, I declare every herald pursuing my life from this region, from this side, from this domain, from this territory, I command you to die. 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 Every herald that want to kill me, every herald that want to imprison me, today, die, die. Let worms eat you up, eat you up, eat you up. Now, now, by fire, by fire, by fire. Herod, you are dead.
Face that side. Stretch your hands.
Every herald.
Hey, hey, what is the problem? Stretch your hands.
Every herald. Every herald opposing me. Every herald resisting me. Today, cut fire. Every herald in my house, every herald in my neighborhood, every herald in my family, every herald in my church, every herald posing as a friend, as a brother, destroying me, taking away my joy, today be exposed, be exposed. Be exposed. Be exposed. Die. Die. By fire. By fire. By thunder. Die. 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 Die.
dead. Face me. The Bible says, clap your hands, all ye people, and shout unto God with the voice of triumph. If you believe your Herod is dead, give the Lord a shout and a clap. Come on, somebody. Yeah. 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 Somebody say 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 yeah. Listen to me. As you shout, there is confusion in the camp of the enemy. As you shout, the kingdom of darkness is tumbling down. As you shout, they are running helter skelter. Somebody say yeah. Oh, give three people a high five and tell them, my Herod is dead. Somebody.
Freedom, 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 than before. I wanna shout louder than before. Oh, 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 oh. I wanna sing louder than before. I wanna spin wider, wider, yeah. Somebody say freedom. Chains, no more bondage. I am free. Yeah. No more shackles, no more chains.
No more shackles, no more chains. No more bondage. I am free.
Yeah. No more shackles, no more chains.
No more shackles, no more chains. No more bondage. I am free.
No
more chains, no more bondage. I am free.
No more shackles, no more shackles, no more chains.
No more shackles, no more chains, no more bondage. I am free.
So sing a sing, 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 hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah,
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 hallelujah.
Hallelujah,
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 hallelujah.
Somebody say yeah. Somebody say yeah. Today the head of Herod is cut off. Just like he's cutting other people's lives off. Today, by the sword of the Spirit, we cut the head of Herod.